Hello! Today we are going to read the Annotated Anuad. This is going to be a history lesson, so to say. But I'm a freak, I find this actually very, very interesting. So let's go for it. The Anuad paraphrased. The first ones were brothers, Anu and Padme. They came into the void, and time began. As Anu and Padme wandered the void, the interplay of light and darkness created Nir. Both Anu and Padme were amazed and delighted with her appearance, but she loved Anu, and Padme retreated from them in bitterness. Nir became pregnant, but before she gave birth, Padme returned, professing his love for Nir. She told him that she loved only Anu, and Padme beat her in rage. As Anu returned, fought Padme and cast him outside time. Nir gave birth to creation, but died from her injuries soon after. Anu, grieving, hid himself in the sun and slept. Meanwhile, life sprang up on the 12 worlds of creation and flourished. After many ages, Padme was able to return to time. He saw creation and hated it. He swung his sword, shattering the 12 worlds and their alignment. Anu awoke and fought Padme again. The long and furious battle ended with Anu, the victor. He cast aside the body of his brother, whom he believed was dead, and attempted to save creation by forming the remnants of the 12 worlds into one, Nirn, the world of Tamriel. As he was doing so, Padme struck him through the chest with one last blow. Anu grappled with his brother and pulled them both outside of time forever. The blood of Padme became the Daedra. The blood of Anu became the stars. The mingled blood of both became the Aedra, hence their capacity for good and evil and their greater affinity for earthly affairs than the Daedra, who have no connection to creation. In the world of Nirn, all was chaos. The only survivors of the 12 worlds of creation were the Elnfei and the Hist. The Elnfei are the ancestors of Mer and Min. The Hist are the trees of Agonia. Nirn originally was all land, with interspersed seas, but no oceans. A large fragment of the Elnfei world landed on Nirn, relatively intact, and the Elnfei living there were the ancestors of the Mer. These Elnfei fortified their borders from the chaos outside, hid their pocket of calm, and attempted to live on as before. Other Elnfei arrived on Nirn, scattered amid the confused jumble of the shattered worlds, wandering and finding each other over the years. Eventually, the wandering Elnfei found the hidden land of old Elnfei, and were amazed and joyful to find their kin living amid the splendor of ages past. The wandering Elnfei expected to be welcomed into the peaceful realm, but the old Elnfei looked on them as degenerates, fallen from their former glory. For whatever reason, war broke out and raged across the whole of Nirn. The old Elnfei retained the ancient power and knowledge, but the wanderers were more numerous and toughened by their long struggle to survive on Nirn. This war reshaped the face of Nirn, sinking much of the land beneath new oceans, and leaving the lands as we know them, Tamriel, Akavir, Admora, and Yakuda. The old Elnfei realm, although ruined, became Tamriel. The remnants of the wanderers were left divided on the other three continents. Over many years, the Elnfei of Tamriel became the Mer, the elves, the Dreamer, the Deep Ones, sometimes called dwarves, the Chimer, the Changed Ones, who later became the Dunmer. The Dunmer, the Dark or Cursed Ones, the Dark Elves. The Bosmer, the Green or Forest Ones, the Wood Elves. The Altmer, the Elder or High Ones, the High Elves. On the other continents, the Wandering Elnafei became the Min, the Nords of Atmora, the Redguards of Yakuda, and the Tsaeshi of Akavir. The Hist were bystanders in the Elnafei War, but most of the realm was destroyed as the war passed over it. A small corner of it survived to become Black Marsh and Tamriel, but most of the realm was sunk beneath the sea. Eventually, Min returned to Tamriel. The Nords were the first, colonizing the northern coast of Tamriel before recorded history, led by the legendary Iskremor. The 13th of his line, King Harald, was the first to appear in written history, and so the mythic era ended. I find this book extremely interesting. Firstly, it is one of the few that actually cover that mythic era, which is before recorded history, and then the Khajiit are missing. This concerns me extremely, because I always play Khajiit, so I wonder. Yeah, whatever, I found it nice. Perhaps you enjoyed it as well. See you soon. Bye-bye. And Merry Christmas.